Okay. My first programming course in my bachelor's degree was called Object-Oriented Programming, and it was in Java. So in that course, I learned the most basic stuff in programming. Things like what is an int, what is a string, what is public, private, what is a class, and so forth. And after that, we also did a course in introduction. It was an introductory course to algorithms and data structures. And in that course, like, the concepts of time complexity was introduced, and also different very basic data structures like linked lists, stacks, queues, and also different sorting algorithms like bubble sort, quick sort, merge sort. And after that course, we also had an introduction to parallel programming, which is really interesting because it was in Go. So Go was the second programming language that I learned. We learned about things like threads, locks, different ways to like prevent deadlocks and so forth, everything that has to do with like concurrency. And after that, we actually did a little bit of assembly. So that was really interesting to do assembly because it's as far away from Java as you can get. It's probably pretty much like as far away from like any programming language you can get. So the thinking is very different. And on top of that, we also did a lot of math courses. I think that's something that people misunderstand about computer science degrees. They think that it's a lot of programming, or expected to be a lot of programming, especially in the beginning. And it's actually not. It's like more maths. So people get pretty shocked when like the first year is like 50% maths. But I did a course in linear algebra, calculus, and numerical methods that year. And I also took a course in human-computer interaction, which didn't involve any type of programming, but was more about like how you should design applications and make prototypes. There was also a course in communication, like how to communicate as an engineer. Year two was a little bit different than year one because it was less of introduction and stuff, and it was more like just dive straight into concepts and new stuff. So we did a course in programming paradigms, in which I got to use Haskell for the first time to for functional programming, and also like Prolog for logical programming, and I also used Java some more for object-oriented programming. And after that, we did a massive course in computer architecture. The first year, we only focused on like the high-level stuff, except the assembly labs. But like the second year was more in-depth about how the computer worked, things like memory hierarchies, processor design, logical gates, input-output, and so forth. And it was a tiny bit of like C programming as well. We also did a course after that in databases. So that was basically SQL, different database models, functions, constraints, and just like how to design the whole architecture of a database. In spring that year, we also did a course in software engineering, which was very different from all the other courses because it wasn't it wasn't really about like labs and going to lectures the ways like most courses are taught. In this course, we were actually divided into groups of 10 people. And each group were assigned to a company, and we got a real world case that the company needed help with. And it was a really interesting course because the focus of it was not like the product itself, it was more about the process of being in software development. And of course, the second year we also did a lot of maths. Like the first year, but this time I did probability theory, stats, logic, and some more calculus. The third year was a little bit different for me because I chose to go on exchange studies in Australia. The courses I took there was algorithms and data structures, like the one I did the first year, but this one was more in-depth. And also it was only C programming, and I didn't do so much C programming, a little bit like in the second year, but like not so much. After doing that course, I felt so much more confident programming in C, and it's really good to know C. I also did a course in information systems, which was a little bit interesting because it wasn't a course that you normally would do as a CS student. It was more a course for management students in IT. That course was actually very interesting because it kind of gave me the perspective of how things looked from the other side. I was used to seeing things from like the CS IT perspective, but it was really interesting to go to the like the management side and see how things looked from the other side. On top of that, I did a course in internet technologies, which was also really good. It was mostly about the different layers in the OSI and TCP/IP, and about like protocols and just like things like address translations and so forth, everything that has to do with networking. So after coming home from my exchange studies, I got really interested in artificial intelligence and decided to do a course in machine learning. So I did an introductory course in machine learning in which I learned supervised, unsupervised learning, decision trees, support vector machines, Bayes classifiers, overfitting, underfitting, etc. Just all like the most fundamental stuff in machine learning were taught to me in that course. And after the machine learning course, I also did a course in deep learning, which was about like neural networks, like recurrent neural networks, convolutional neural networks, backpropagation, just really the most common types of neural networks and how they work. And I also did a course in operating systems, and the operating system course was actually a very good course. It kind of brought everything together. It was like the missing piece in my whole education at that point because it bridged the hardware stuff and the software parts of computer science. It was mostly about like how the operating system managed the computer's resources such as memory and processing units, and just distributed those resources between the applications that were running on the computer. And finally, I wrote my bachelor's thesis. I wrote about recommender systems, which is kind of related to machine learning, and that involved some Python programming as well. So yeah, there you go, my computer science degree in a couple of minutes. I hope you guys enjoyed the video, and I'll see you in my next one. Bye!